Hello everyone and welcome to We Meet at Digital Days. My name is Lisa Richter and I will moderate this presentation. We are very pleased that you took the time to participate in our virtual conference. The topic of this presentation is 27-watt USB Type-C Power Delivery 3.0 with PPS Adapter Reference Design. Our speakers are from our partner ST Microelectronics, Filippo Bonaccorso and Fabrizio Di Franco. They will hold the presentation and will answer your questions. Before we start, I would like to point out one thing. You will be muted during the presentation. This means that you cannot ask questions via the microphone during the presentation. Nevertheless, you have the opportunity to ask questions during the presentation at any time via the chat function. You will find the chat function in the control panel. This presentation will be about 30 minutes long, and the chat questions will be answered in a Q&A session following the webinar. There are 5 to 10 minutes left or scheduled for this, and if we are unable to answer all of your questions within this time, we will answer them via email afterwards. If you still have any other questions left, just mail us at exhibition@we-online.com. And we will try to answer all of your questions promptly. At the end of the webinar, you'll be asked to participate in a feedback survey. We would be pleased if you take the time to fill out the survey and help us to improve our event. You will receive the link to the presentation in the next few days, and the recording will be available at our website shortly. So now I will hand over to our speakers, and I wish you an exciting presentation.
Okay, so we can start. So, hi everyone, my name is Fabrizio Di Franco from ST Microelectronics. And first of all, let me thank you, our Burta Electronics friends, for having invited us to this Digital Days exhibition. Today, together with the application specialist Filippo Bonaccorso, we are going to tell you about our new reference design in power conversion, the ST-Evalue SBPD27S, the 27-watt USB Type-C Power Delivery 3.0 adapter with PPS support. The solution extensively embeds in the bill of material Wurth Electronics components for what concern passives and magnetics. So taking a closer look at the content of the presentation, we will go first shortly through the market trend, then we will move to the hardware architecture and key products overview, ST key products overview. Then we will move to the firmware package structure, which complements the solution, while in the second portion of the presentation, we will focus on the major IPs developed for this solution and which bring the real added value to the addressed final customer applications. We will end this presentation with some experimental results and some useful details about the full set of documentation available for this solution. The trend for AC-to-DC power adapters for mobile devices has moved from traditional, let's say, low power fixed output power supplies for mobile devices to today's higher power level, higher power density, and variable output solutions, including and supporting multiple communication protocols, including the USB power delivery. In this trend, there is a major focus on fast charging solutions for mobile devices, since their battery capacities continue to increase and the charging time needs to be reduced. Now, in this trend, modern fast charging applications require more and more programmable power supply capability, so PPS support, who makes possible for faster and safer charging without unnecessary heat, and who makes also possible for the execution of specific and custom charging profiles, both cost and voltage and cost and current. So to meet this market trend, we recently launched this ST-Evalue USB27S reference design to address the mobile power adapters and fast charger applications as well as the outlet wall adapter applications. With an extensive technology and IPs portfolio, ST is able to offer a wide range of USB IF certified solution for USB Type-C and power delivery in order to support implementations in a variety of source, sync, and dual role devices. Specifically for source devices, so for AC to DC adapters, ST offer covers from the AC receptacle to the Type-C receptacle. So for the power supply stage, so for the first stage, let's say, we are offering, let's say, a double approach. I mean, the entry-level approach with the STCH03 PWM controller for quasi-resonant flyback topology, coupled in this case with the super junction power MOSFET, so with the MD Mesh M6 series, specifically optimized for soft switching topologies, but also offering high performances in hard switching topologies, or the very high efficiency approach with the Master GaN family recently introduced into the market. The Master GaN, as you may be aware, is the system in package with the half bridge high voltage gate driver and two GaN FETs to address high frequency converters, such as the active clamp flyback converter or the LLC converter, up to 100 watt or even even higher power rating. For what concern the secondary side, so the USB Type-C and PD 3.0 controller, ST offer a wide flexibility, let's say, thanks to the MCU-based approach or thanks to the hardwired approach to implement different use cases with different power ratings. For what concerns the MCU-based approach, there are, let's say, two options are available. The first option for PPS is based on the certified USB C and power delivery STM32 microcontrollers, thanks to the USB Type-C and power delivery interface IP, which has been introduced first with the STM32G0 series, but now available also with the G4 series, the L5 series, and the U5 series. In this case, the companion chip, the companion IC of the STM32 microcontroller will be the TCPP0X protection, which is basically interfacing the micro with the Type-C port, and which is providing all the protections needed for the use case. So the V-bus or the CC line protections on top of other functions, such as the gate driving for the load switch and the bus discharge. The other option for the MCU based is including any STM32 with the X-Cube USB PD certified software, and in this case the companion chip will be the USB ST USB 1602 Type-C controller, while, as I mentioned before, we have also in our portfolio the hardwired option, which will be based on the USB ST USB 47 full hardware controllers. Now I leave the stage to Filippo Bonaccorso, who will go into more technical details of this presentation and this solution.
Thank you, Fabrizio. Thank you, everyone, for joining. Let's start with more details on the STIVAL USB PD 27S. As you can see from all the key features, this is a 27 watt adapter based on STM32G0 that is compliant with Type-C and PD 3.0 specification. And particularly, the solution is able to support programmable power supply or PPS. The board is operating from a wide range AC input and is offering four PDOs, two fixed one and two programmable one, the one related to PPS. And thanks to the transformer designed jointly with Wurt, it is able to offer up to 5 amp output. Then the board, thanks to the firmware package, is able to support with its software IPs many tasks driven by the MCU. So not only the power delivery communication, but also synchronous rectification and particularly the control of the VBUS to cope with PPS. It is compliant with COC Tier 2 and DOE Level 6, and is able to, it has a very low standby power consumption that is less than 40 milliwatts. It is a very compact solution, thanks to the 3D shape of the three PCB module used, and is able to reach more than 10 watts per inch cube. So, as I said before, we are offering 4 PDOs, 2 of which are PPS, programmable power supply PDOs. This feature will be described later, and is mainly targeting mobile charging application. The key product of the 3D structure is shown in this picture. As you can see, we have a main board offering the main stage of the flyback converter, and we have a small board that is managing the flyback converter based on the STCH03, and a digital control board where the MCU coupled with the TCPIP01 device is managing all the stack and all the application in all its features. So not only the STCH03, as said before by Fabrizio, is in charge of the power conversion, but we have also MDMesh M6 MOSFET, and we have also an LDO on the main stage that is supplying all the digital control section that is based on the first MCU, the STM32G0, that is offering the PD-PHY, with the TCPIP01 that is managing the interface with the Type-C connector. And there are also the MOSFET in charge of turning on and off the VBUS with other protection on the VBUS. So going into details, moving from the AC input to the Type-C output, we have the STCH03 that is a key product for flyback converters because it is offering many interesting features. First of all, the low current consumption and the low standby consumption. It offers frequency jittering to reduce the MEI, and it has also an high voltage startup circuit. And in the topology used, there's also a different snubber that is based not on the classical RC approach, but is based on a transient voltage suppressor. This helps the board to achieve a higher efficiency, especially at light load. The STCH03 is coupled with the STD7N65 MOSFET, that is belonging to a family of products that are mainly targeting this kind of solution, so mainly software switching device, and it has high efficiency, especially in terms of RDS-on. Last but not least, on the primary, on the power stage, we have the LDK320, that is an high precision, high efficiency LDO that is providing, that can provide up to 200 milliamp, that is supplying all the digital control stage. The digital control stage is based mainly on the MCU that is in charge of all the tasks said before, that is STM32G0, that has a very large set of IP that are in the solution that are used jointly with software IP. So the probably the most important one is the USB PD PHY, but all other IPs are in charge of some specific action in this solution. The TCP/PoE1 is in charge of the protection of the MCU, because you may have surge or shorts on the Type-C connector. And this device is also offering other features like overvoltage protection and mainly the gate driving for the load switch, because Type-C spec imply the application to turn on and off the bus output. This is the first device of this family, but today there are coming other devices, TCP/PoE2 and TCP/PoE3, that will address mainly source and DRP application. On the VBUS, we have also another transient voltage suppressor that is in charge of protecting your application. The board, as said, is based on an MCU, so there's a firmware package that is based on CubeG0 firmware package, especially for the USB PD library, that is offering also other software IPs that are managing different aspects of the application. The two most important ones are the signals rectification and the programmable power supply, the VBUS management. So let's move on with programmable power supplies. Programmable power supplies are an optional feature of PD 3.0 standard and implies a precise control of the VBUS, because the charger has to change the output with 20 millivolt resolution on the voltage output and 50 milliamp resolution on the output current. Moreover, it has to deal with constant voltage operation and constant current operation. This optional feature is very useful, especially for battery charging application. One of the main target of PPS is to replace the charger on mobile device, because of with PPS, the sync device that could be a smartphone or a tablet can ask directly to the charger a specific voltage and current with the option of constant voltage and constant current to charge directly its battery without losing power in heat or losing efficiency in the conversion, because everything is managed by the charger. The standard imply the use of a specific set of mandatory power data object, but in this case, as said before, due to the features of the transformer, the solution is able to provide up to 5 amp on the first two profile, which means that at 5 volt or in the first augmented PDO, the solution is able to provide up to 5 amp if an electronically marked cable is used. To offer all this feature, a control algorithm has been developed for the VBUS. So this control algorithm has to deal with all the requests coming from the sync side and has to offer the bus with the resolution imposed by the spec. So in this picture, you can see one of the tests done with tool equipment, where the voltage is changed with 20, 100 or 50 millivolt step. But as said before, Even a constant current operation is requested. On the left side of the screen, you can see the request from the spec, the USB PD standard. On the right, you can see a picture acquired with the scope that is replicating the requested behavior. Anyway, don't be scared, because more information are available on the online documentation of the board. Another software IP that is running on the MCU is the synchronous rectification. The MCU is able to cope with the synchronous rectification. That is a feature offered in power conversion that is used to increase the efficiency and to reduce the thermal dissipation. The key point of the synchronous rectification is the use of a MOSFET instead of a diode. So the key point of the synchronous rectification is that the MOSFET is controlled to work as a diode. Doing so, you are gaining in efficiency, because a lower Edison MOSFET is used instead of a diode. So the key point is to increase the MOSFET conduction point to increase the efficiency. So in the classical flyback topology, when the VDS on the secondary side is going down, that means that the ideal diode should start to conduct, the MOSFET is turned on to reduce the resistance on the bus, and it is turned off when the current is approaching zero. Anyway, there are blinking windows offered at turn on and turn off to avoid noise, to avoid false triggering, but at the end, the algorithm has to maximize the MOSFET conduction time. To do so, there is a patented algorithm that is acquiring the voltage on the MOSFET just after the turn-off, and on the basis of the voltage at the turn-off is able to detect if the conduction time of the MOSFET must be increased or reduced. Even for this, there is a specific application note that is describing how to implement synchronous rectification on a flyback converter. Let's move on with all the experimental result of the board. First of all, we can see the output voltage regulation in case of dynamic load variation. In this picture acquired with the scope, we can see how the board is controlling the VBUS when the current is switching from zero to the full load at 10 Hz. So the output is well inside the requested spec from USB power delivery. The flyback topology put in place uses a 650 volt MOSFET on the primary side and a 100 volt MOSFET on the secondary side. So you can see that the voltage on the primary side MOSFET and the secondary side MOSFET are well below the maximum voltage available. The synchronous rectification algorithm behavior is shown in this picture. The pink one is the voltage on the primary side MOSFET, while the yellow one is a translation in the MCU domain of the secondary side MOSFET voltage. So you can see that once the primary side MOSFET is turned off, the secondary side one is turned on, and you can see in blue the PWM that is turning on the MOSFET that is directly generated by the MCU and is controlling the super low G level MOSFET. The power efficiency, as said, is in line with COC TR2 and the OE level 6 requirement. And last, but not least, even the MEI are well inside the mask, and this is also due to the specific design of the transformer that is offering a double shielding approach. All the experimental results are hosted inside an application note. The board is compliant with all the USB PD spec, but we can say that it is almost certified because we are waiting for the official communication from USB.org. So the board will be certified as 27 watt power brick, and the MCU will be certified as source with PPS support. Then additional information, if you buy the board, you will find this blister with the Steval USB PD 27S, with Nesty Link programmer, that is the tool that can be used to program and to play with the solution. Don't be scared, because we are rich of document describing the board and describing how to deal with USB PD and with all the programming tool. Now I leave the stage again to Fabrizio for a final conclusion.
Okay, so trying to summarize, ST has recently launched this USB Type-C and power delivery 3.0 reference design with PPS support to accelerate the design of easy to use, efficient and compact power adapters up to 27 watt with basically zero power when no cable is connected. As takeaways, first of all, the solution is based on the MCU approach. So it is based on the STM32G0 microcontroller. And this is giving the flexibility to follow up the evolution of the power delivery standard, and at the same time to implement additional application layers such as the synchronous rectification. Then, as shown during the technical portion of the presentation, specific algorithms have been developed to control and to regulate the VBUS on the secondary side to reach the compliance with the power delivery and the power delivery standard and the PPS specification. And the microcontroller is also used to control the synchronous rectification, as mentioned, with a unique adaptive algorithm, basically. For what concerns the performances, so for the energy, for the power conversion efficiency, we reached the target of the compliance with the most stringent energy saving recommendations, both for what concern the let's say steady state efficiency, but also for the standby, so the no load power consumption, which is actually less than 40 milliwatt. So I think that's it for the presentation. Thanks a lot for your attention, and then we can move to the Q&A session.
So thank you very much. Yes, like you already mentioned, we can go now to the Q&A, and therefore everybody has the opportunity to ask questions via the chat function in the panel. So let's have a look. Maybe a first question: which is the converter topology used?
So in this case, for the power stage, so for the converter, we are implementing a quasi-resonant flyback converter. So single switch topology, very simple, but at the same time efficient and compact. So the answer is a quasi-resonant flyback converter.
Okay, great. Then another question: which device allows the QR flyback converter control?
In this case we are using the STCH03 PWM controller, which is also offering the primary side the constant current feature, while the constant voltage is implemented on the secondary side. So STCH03PWM controller.
Okay. Then there is another question. Does Devio Contact have any solution for power over Ethernet?
Yes. Of course, in our portfolio, we do have controllers for the power over Ethernet addressing the latest standard, so up to 7 watt and even more. So the portfolio is including both PoE interfaces with the active bridge and the hotspot controller, and also the PoE, the PWM controller for implementing the power conversion from the 48 volt to the desired output voltage. Specifically, for the power delivery combined with the PoE standard, we do have it in our roadmap. So in our roadmap, there is this reference design to address up to 100 watt USB power type C and power delivery applications with PoE as a main protocol for the supply voltage, let's say.
Okay. Then there is a question. Yes, first of all, thank you. I think I lost the drift of transient response time. Could you mention it again?
Okay, the response time, especially for the voltage transition, are only in line with the USB PD spec. I don't have it in mind right now, but you can find it on the documentation available online.
Okay, great. Then another question. Which devices allow the PD protocol implementation?
Okay, the PD protocol implementation is based on two items. The first one is the USB PD PHY that is an hardware IP on the STM32G0 MCU that is joined with the USB PD library available on the STM32CubeG0, that is the firmware package for the MCU. And the library is dealing with all the items related to the USB PD standard.
Okay. And then maybe a last question. What's the meaning of PPS? Which is its use?
PPS means programmable power supplies, and is the optional feature described before that is offering the smaller resolution on the BBUS and on the current from 3.3 volt up to the maximum voltage available on the board.
Okay. So thank you both of you. This was really great. Thank you for having you here today. And thank you all for your attention. I hope you enjoyed the presentation. So the next presentation topic is make electronics autonomous and powered from environment. And the presentation starts at 5. Hopefully see you there and enjoy the digital days. So goodbye.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Bye.
Bye. Have a good day.
Good day.